How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I want to show you guys how you can get yourself a Chile IP address. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. So just for you beginners out there, just to kind of explain how a VPN can get you a Chile IP address. Now, to hide your actual IP address from websites, you need to send your traffic through another location. You also have to make sure that the sites can't trace your data back to your connection. Top quality VPNs have security servers around the world. They use military grade encryption to create a hidden tunnel between your device and any server you choose. When your traffic reaches its destination, the website only sees the IP address of the VPN server. Just sign up for a reliable VPN and choose a Chilean server, and all your internet activity will have an IP address in Chile. Websites in the country will drop their geo-blocks and give you access to anything you need. With a Chilean IP address from a reliable VPN, you can see Chilean exclusive streaming services, as well as stream Netflix Chile, or watch the Chilean Primera Division from anywhere. Using your online bank accounts to pay bills in Chilean pesos will also be as easy as if you were in Santiago. You can also get access to exclusive Chilean news coverage in regional social networks. If you do business in Chile, you can spot trends in local markets before any of your competitors. However, conducting business or financial transactions online always puts you at risk of cybercrime, especially if you're traveling or using public Wi-Fi. This is where free IP changing services, proxies, and so-called free VPNs will let you down. Free proxies use peer-to-peer networks that give other users access to your connection. Meanwhile, a lot of free VPNs collect and sell your browsing data. The ones with decent security have slow speeds and bandwidth limits that make them, which makes them bad choices for streaming. These are the three VPNs that I'm going to recommend. And obviously, these are some of the best VPNs you can find in the business. And I wouldn't be choosing them if they didn't have any Chilean IPs. So here we have the Chilean location or server, and with NordVPN, if you just zoom in right here, you'll notice Chile is also covered. And if we just scroll down a little bit or look it up right here, we will see the Chile server in Surfshark. It is as simple as that. Okay, so let me just bring over what is my ip-address.com. And getting a Chilean IP address is as simple as, let's just say we're going to be using ExpressVPN here, okay? And all you have to do is, it says that I'm in Switzerland, and that's because I was connected to Switzerland earlier when I loaded up what is my IP address. But now I'm going to connect to Chile. Now, the result that we should be seeing is that the country right here will be Chile. So let's see what happens here when I give it a quick refresh. And when it comes to getting a Chile IP address, it really is as simple as that. There we go, City Santiago. So that is pretty much it. It doesn't get much simpler than that. Okay, so how do you know which one of these VPNs could be the best choice for you? Well, it depends on what you're looking for out of the VPN. Now, ExpressVPN has over 3,000 servers in 94 countries and will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. ExpressVPN has basic features such as the internet kill switch, which is called network lock in Express, and split tunneling. Now, if you're not familiar with these, the kill switch will make sure that you're only connected to the internet when you're secured by the VPN. So if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, it will also disconnect your internet connection, making sure that you don't connect back to the ISP servers, making sure that you don't connect back to your internet service provider's servers and only be connected through the VPN secured servers. Now, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So you could only have, for example, your torrenting client routed through the VPN while the rest of your network is left intact or untouched by the VPN connection. Or the other way around, where you could have select applications bypass the VPN connection, while the rest of your network is secured by the VPN. Okay, so let's say you're looking for a VPN that is a little bit more budget-friendly, and that would be NordVPN with over 5,100 servers in 60 countries. Now, even though NordVPN has 34 less countries than ExpressVPN, as you can tell, it is still quite the number at 60 countries. You'll be able to secure up to 6 devices per subscription, though, and a whole bunch of security features such as specialty servers, as you can tell here, with a dedicated IP, double VPN, onion over VPN, and peer-to-peer. And of course, you've got an ad blocker right here, and the very quick and best performing protocol, Nord Links. Keep in mind, when you switch to Nord Links, you will lose access to double VPN and dedicated IP. And unless you need these specific specialty servers, I would just recommend that you stick to Nord Links, which is a very quick protocol. In fact, so quick that you don't want to use anything else. Not only do you get the conventional kill switch, but you also get the app kill switch, which will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops, rather than disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional kill switch. Split tunneling. You've got also custom DNS, which is an easy way to change your DNS, and obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship-heavy country. Now, if you're looking for the most budget-friendly VPN, that would be Surfshark. Surfshark has over 3,200 servers in 65 countries, which makes it a very convenient option for those wanting to secure a whole bunch of devices with just one subscription, because it will allow you to virtually secure an unlimited number of devices with just one subscription. And it being such a budget-friendly VPN, without necessarily sacrificing much on security, performance, or features for that matter, makes it a very enticing VPN for most people, especially those that don't want to spend a whole lot, at least on their first VPN experience. So you still get multi-hop and static IP, which are the same as double VPN and dedicated IP from NordVPN. And if you don't know what these are, by the way, static IP will give you, well, static IP addresses, which means that these servers have IPs that are set and do not change. Multi-hop will route your connection through two servers, as you can tell, rather than one, for double the protection, making it extra difficult to track you. And in these settings here, you will notice that we still get whitelister, which is split tunneling, it's just called whitelister here, the kill switch, an ad blocker, as well as a handful of protocols. For the most part, you just want to use the best performing protocol. Again, that'll be the WireGuard protocol. It's so quick that you don't want to use anything else. You've got IKEV2, which is a good protocol. It's pretty quick. Extra security will be offered by OpenVPN, both UDP and TCP, and Shadow Socks will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country, though it will only secure your browser traffic, so keep that in mind, and No Borders mode will help you bypass the Great Firewall of China if you are in China or any other censorship-heavy country, for that matter. And, you know, if you notice that ExpressVPN doesn't really have any obfuscated kind of options here for obfuscation and whatnot, that's because ExpressVPN actually has obfuscation on by default. It's always on, and you don't have to go through any sort of configuration or toggle any kind of option in order to turn it on. All you have to do is download it, and it will work whether you're in China, outside of China, in any other censorship-heavy country, it doesn't matter. That's, of course, part of the ease of use with ExpressVPN. So that'll be it for this video, guys. Keep in mind that all these VPNs are covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee. So no matter which VPN you decide to go for, you will be able to claim the refund. Let me just show you guys very quickly. So if I go ahead and get ExpressVPN, you'll notice that all these VPNs, it says there are 30-day money-back guarantees on them. So even if you just go for the one-month plan, you will be able to claim the refund through the 24/7 live chat support. By the way, it's the same with NordVPN and Surfshark. All you need to do is hover over the bottom right, and you'll be able to access the live chat support, the 24/7 live chat support, where they will help you with your refund or any other question you might be having about these VPNs. Again, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below for all of these VPNs, and you'll also find full reviews that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to check those out if you guys are interested. That'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.